In this video, we want to answer the question, what is calculus all about? To answer this question, I've drawn a straight line. And you already know, a straight line has the same slope at every point. Here or here or here, you have always the same slope. Now, how can I calculate the slope of this straight line? I must draw a slope triangle. I do this. This is a slope triangle. You already know what a slope triangle is. Now I have here delta x and here I have delta y. And the slope is, the change in y, you write delta y, divided by the change in x, you write delta x. Now we come to a new problem. We want to calculate the slope of a curve. At first I draw a curve, for example this curve. Okay. Now you must realize that a straight line has the same slope at every point, but a curve has a different slope at every point, usually. For example, you have here a small slope and you have here a big slope. Now we can answer the question, what is calculus all about? Differential calculus means to calculate the slope of a curve. But how can we do that? Imagine that you are standing on the beach and looking at the horizon. I draw the horizon. This is the horizon. And this is the sun. And this is a ship. Now I ask you, what is the horizon? Is it a straight line or a curve? I assume that you say the horizon is a straight line. But that's not right. The horizon is part of the Earth. I draw the Earth. This is the Earth. And if you look at the horizon, you look at this part of the Earth, this part of this curve. The Earth, if you look from here, the Earth is a curve. A circle is a curve. And if you look at a small part of this curve, the curve looks like a straight line, the horizon. Now we can solve our problem. For example, I want to know what is the slope at this point. Then I look at a small part of this curve, for example, this small part. And I've said, if I look at a small part of a curve, it is a straight line. If I look at a small part of a curve, it is a straight line. I consider this as a straight line. It's not exactly a straight line, but I consider it as a straight line. I'll tell you more in a few moments. Now, if this part of the curve is a straight line, I can draw a slope triangle. Okay, I draw the slope triangle. This is my slope triangle. This is delta y and this is delta x. Okay, now I ask myself, how long is delta x? Here I have x and this point is x plus delta x. Now I can answer the question, how long is this side of the triangle? This side has the length x plus delta x minus x. In the same way, I can calculate the length of this side of the triangle. Here I have the function value f of x. Now this is x and this is f of x. And here I have the function value of x plus delta x. X plus delta x. And the length of this side of the triangle is f of x plus delta x minus f of x. Now I can write down the slope of this curve at this point. The slope is this side divided by this side, or in this example, this side divided by this side. And this side, delta y, how long is this side of the triangle? The length is f of x plus delta x, f of x plus delta x minus f of x. Okay, and how long is this side of the triangle? This side is x plus delta x minus x. X plus delta x minus x. And this x and this x cancel each other out. Okay, and I have this formula. But we have made a small error. We have said this is a straight line. If we look at a small part of a curve, it is a straight line. But it is not really a straight line. So I must write the slope is nearly this formula. To find the exact slope of this curve at this point, we must calculate the limit. The limit as delta x goes to zero. Because if delta x goes to zero, this part of the curve becomes a straight line. I draw another curve and explain to you what I mean. We have said if we have a curve and we look at a small part of this curve, the small part of the curve looks like a straight line, roughly. If we choose a smaller part of the curve, the part of the curve looks more like a straight line. Therefore, we must choose a very, very small part of the curve, here and here. And we do this by choosing delta x very, very small. If we choose delta x very, very small, we look at a very, very small part of the curve. And the smallest delta x is if delta x goes to zero. We must calculate the limit of this as delta x goes to zero. So I must write the slope is the limit as delta x goes to zero. The limit of this fraction. Yes, if the delta x goes to zero, we look at a very small part of this curve, and this fraction becomes the slope. And this is the most important formula of differential calculus, and in the next video I show you how to use this formula if a concrete function is given, for example f of x equals x to the power of n. Okay, that's the end. Goodbye.